Hein? Well, did I press the wrong thing? Is this another dream? It's getting sort of toasty. Do I smell burning? No. No, hell no. Hell yeah! Let's go talk to Lucifer! We're at a burning restaurant. This is fine. Not. Why am I in a burning diner?
Hoi! Welcome to Uncle Mugen's Oh Fuck Everything Diner. Here you can make reservations for birthdays, weddings, and sacrificial rituals. If you're interested in the last option, you will need to reserve at least a month in advance. It's quite a popular service here.
Oh no. I am not dealing with you today. Get out of my dream. Player, please wake me up now. Help me out. You know how to sing, right? Just do anything. Yell at me. Make up an alarm sound or something. I am not talking to Lucy Goosey tonight. What was it? Phone ring done. Phone alarm. Play alarm clock ringing. Scream into his face like a cowboy. Well, I don't want to wake him up, so I'll do this one. What is this song? Eep. Is he gonna scream? Waiting for a scream. It's all just music. The memes are strong with this one. Are you in pain? You don't sound like a cowboy at all. You sounded more like a cat getting his tail stepped on.
Hey, don't leave yet. You haven't even tried the food here. Here, try these fried chicken fingers. Fried chick fingers? It's this diner's signature dish. Best paired with Belial's bastard sauce. Best hot sauce in hell.
No thanks. Hold up. I look closer at the thin fried things on the plate. Something's wrong. Underneath the breadcrumbs were. What the fuck? Are they actual, like, women fingers? These are real fingers.
Yeah, that's what I said. Chick fingers.
What? Statement of question.
Don't worry, they are harvested fresh from a locally sourced, certified organic sinner chick. This lady had everything in her life: happy childhood, good friends, good parents, good education, and eventually she found a lucrative job. Married a rich hunk guy, had two wealthy, good-hearted children who were later very successful in their lives. Yet this lady had a flaw, the flaw of narcissism. Nothing's ever her fault in her own eyes. She pointed fingers at the innocent while she's the responsible one. Some drama happened between her and another work colleague, and so she devised a revenge plot. Workplace sabotage happened. She did it, of course, and she pointed her finger at the colleague. No one suspected the upstanding employee that was this bitch in sheep's clothing, and so the proverbial good crewmate was ejected out of the ship into space. The chick ruined her colleague's whole career and marriage. Eventually, the poor soul overdosed and came here with a heart full of darkness. The best part? This bitch felt no remorse, even after hearing the news of her ex-colleague's death. She was damn pleased at what she had accomplished. And she got away with it her whole life. Until now, that is. The chef seasoned her fingers with salt from her victim's tears of pain, and that's what gave this dish its impeccable flavor and 5-star rating. Come on, try it. You won't regret it. I can order more if you like it.
More? How can there be more?
Hey, she's a tortured soul. Her fingers grow back in minutes. Then the chef can harvest it again.
Okay, no, stop. Shut up. I'm not eating that. I ain't a cannibal.
Nah, suit yourself. More for me, then.
He just picked up one of the fingers, dipped it in the black burning sauce, and ate it while it's still on fire. And that story, was it supposed to help me appreciate this dish? Literally, what the hell? No, I think I'm gonna be sick. Get me out of here now!
Sheesh, can't you be more civilized and actually listen to what I have to say before bailing?
Me be more civilized? Seriously? This coming from the devil himself, who just ate some poor girl's deep-fried finger? Well, that funny description didn't sound like a poor girl at all.
Boy, don't be a racist cunt. Devils can be civilized too. Just ask Sebastian Michaelis, Sadao Mao, or Meliodas.
Who? It's me too.
Never mind. So, I suppose congratulations are in order. You actually managed to save your girlfriend.
I wasn't trying, really.
With my generous helping hand, of course. Don't thank me, please. Your applause is not necessary.
I'm not clapping.
Shut up.
My mouth's shut. I'm using telepathy.
Fuck you. Point is, you have chosen my path, and that is good. This is freedom. This is liberation. Revenge is sweet, yet it takes a lot of courage to reap the fruit. Welp, good thing you ain't a pussy. I think I'm starting to like you. No homo. Just holler if you need me next time. Remember to keep a low profile, foe. No one should know, not even your girlfriend. Good luck trying to free Yuri. She's one disturbing character. Forgot to capitalize his S. She's also my fave, the foe. Wonder if she'll be my waifu if I asked. Is that what just fucking kidding is what that stands for? I don't know. Really? Giving me the silent treatment? Not cool, man. Not cool. Ah, well. Time for you to wake up anyway. Try not to get stabbed.
Excuse me?
Now fuck off.
Morning. I don't want to talk about whatever just happened. I don't even want to get out of bed anymore. Something smells delicious. Knock, knock.
Howie, are you awake?
Sayori?
Come on, you're going to be late for school.
Sayori gently opened the door.
Good morning, Howie. Good morning to you too, player.
Morning, Sayori. Good morning, Sayori. He's saying it. Yawn.
Did you sleep well?
Had a nightmare last night, but otherwise I'm okay.
Really? Oh no, that's no good. Nightmares can cause you to not focus in class. Take it from me.
Huh, wise words from the experienced.
However, not to worry. I'm sure the breakfast I made for you can cheer you up.
Wait, what statement of my question? You made breakfast? Seriously?
Yep. Come on, I can't wait for you to have a taste of my cooking.
Wow, okay. I jump out of bed immediately. Does she make cereal? She grabbed my hand and practically pulled me downstairs to the kitchen. The oily aroma of fried breakfast foods intensifies. Whoa! In front of me on the dining table are two plates of bacon and scrambled eggs with some pancakes alongside two glasses of milk. The bacon doesn't look burnt, and the eggs look golden. Or present tense, look, don't need the ED. You actually did all this?
Yeah, it looks pretty good, right? I followed the recipe and this time it worked!
Well, I gotta see how it tastes first. I sat down and take a knife and fork in each hand. Tentatively, I scoop up some eggs with my fork and shove it in my mouth. Oh. I pick up a piece of bacon with my free hand and bite into it. I cut a piece of pancake and ate it as well.
So, how was it? I mean, this is the first time I tried cooking and not fail, so I gotta be a bit excited.
It's, how should I say it? This is the best thing I have ever tasted in my life.
Yeah, I know it's not that good. Nani? You really think so?
Heh. To prove my point, I consume my breakfast ravenously. Yes, the eggs are a bit overcooked, even if they looked creamy. Needs a little salt, too. And yes, the pancakes are a bit chewy. The bacon is fine, though. Crisp and not burnt. Overall, it's not perfect, but it is the best thing I had ever tasted. I mean, a breakfast made by the one person I love. And adding the fact that she tried her best to do it despite her condition. There's no other answer. Clink. Gochi Chusama, that was delicious.
Thank you, Howie. I guess I'm not a burden after all, right?
I stand up, walk towards her, and pinch her cheeks.
What?
This is punishment for saying stupid stuff. I told you yesterday you're not a burden, so please stop saying that you are one. It hurts to hear you berate yourself like this.
Sorry. I guess I'm still not confident enough yet.
I let her go and smiled. You just need to learn to love yourself a bit more.
Okay. I forgot! Quick, change into your school uniform, you're gonna be late!
Now she sounds like a doting mother, which warms my heart. Okay. Minutes of changing later.
Ready to go?
Yep, see you later. Love you.
Stay safe, I love you too!
With a suave smile and a cool wave, I walk out of the door with confidence. Alright, let's go!
Hi again, Hallie.
What the?
Glad to see you didn't run away on us!
What the hell just... I hadn't even started to walk to school... No! Oh no, 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 no! You noticed what just happened, player? We got King Crimsoned again! Just right after I stepped out of the house, we skipped to the next original part of the script! Just how unstable did Monica made this world? Make this world! Ha, keep it together, just follow the script first, yes. Ahem. Nah, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but I at least keep my word. While I'm back at the literature club, I was the last to come in. Reed glitched in, so everyone else is already hanging out.
Thanks for keeping your promise, Ellie. I hope this isn't too overwhelming of a commitment for you. Making you dive headfirst into literature when you're not accustomed to it.
So I don't actually know if this was pure random chance or intentional, but there's that. Yuri, your face?
Oh, come on, like you deserve any slack!
Natsuki, you okay?
You already had to be dragged here by Monika. I don't know if you plan to just come here and hang out or what, but if you don't take us seriously, then you won't see the end of it.
Natsuki, you certainly have been gone for someone who keeps that wrong with the collection in the club room.
Monika, scoot over a bit, will ya?
Natsuki
finds herself stuck between saying Monika and a manga.
Manga is literature!
Swiftly defeated, Natsuki plops back into her seat. I think the chair glitched a little bit, or maybe it's a trick of the light.
I'm sorry, Ellie. We'll make sure to put you in front first, okay?
Yuri shoots Natsuki with a disappointed glance.
Anyway, now that you're in the club and all, perhaps you might have interest in picking up a book to read.
Well, I can't really say no either way. Like I said, I'm in this club right now, so it only feels right for me to do something like that if you ask.
Well, wait, I didn't mean it like that. If you don't really want to, then forget I said anything, I guess.
No, it's not that, Yuri. I want to try to be a part of this club. So even if I don't read often, I'll be happy to pick up a book if you wanted me to.
Oh, are you sure? I just felt like, well, as vice president and all, that I should help you get started on something you might like.
Yuri just into her bag and pulls out a book.
I didn't want you to feel left out, so I picked out a book that I thought you might enjoy. It's a short read, so it should keep your attention, even if you don't usually read. And we could, you know, discuss it if you wanted.
Yep, let's see. Yep, same book. I still have another copy at home, though. Wonder if some form of parallel universe paradox thing would occur if I were to put those books near to each other. You know, like D4C and JoJo Part 7? No, I don't. Whatever, just a stupid thought. Yuri, thank you. I'll definitely read this. I take the book with feigned enthusiasm. Feeling real bad now, having to fake all this to follow the plot. Life ain't worth living when you have to constantly be a faker or just an actor. You don't, man, you don't. If this already feels this bad, oh god. I can't imagine what Sayori must have felt. To constantly fake being happy in front of me when she's already feeling miserable. You need like a semicolon here or a comma here, and this needs to all be part of the same sentence. Days, send her a bouquet of flowers from me, would ya? Or better yet, open a flower shop so I can get one for her myself.
Phew. Well, you can read it at your own pace. I look forward to hearing what you think.
And with that, Yuri walked away serenely. Is it just me, or does the background music sounded strange to you? It could go either way. Because this song is actually only different right at the start of it for the glitched song. So it sounds normal right now. But if you're going to go too past it, you have to say, is it just me, or did the background music sound strange? And you wouldn't need the ED here. But yeah. Also, I feel a bit dizzy. Oof! Well, that's better. Everything's straightened once again. Out of my head. Well, let's see. Yuri's face is already buried in a book. I can't help but notice her intense expression, like she was waiting for this chance. Well, she's gonna be the next to be liberated. Let's check on her first, shall we? Okay. So Yuri doesn't seem to be showing any Gandari tendencies yet. No, wait, she's very good at hiding her ugly side. I gotta be careful. She notices me looking at her. She sneaks another glance at me, and our eyes meet for a split second. But that only makes her hide her face deeper in her book. Sorry, I was just spacing out. Damn it, I made her uncomfortable.
Oh, it's fine. If I was focused, then I probably wouldn't have noticed in the first place. But I'm just rereading a bit of this, so...
Yuri? Your eye is floating away from you. You're gonna get that? No? Oh, okay. That's the book that you gave me, right?
I wanted to reread some of it. Not for any particular reason.
Her eyes back. Just curious, how come you have two copies of the same book?
Well, when I stopped at the bookstore yesterday, that's not what I meant. I mean, I just happened to buy two of them.
Ah, I see. Just happened to buy two of them, sure. Oh, Yuri. Stick to the script. I'll definitely start reading it soon.
I'm glad to hear. Once it starts to pick up, you might have a hard time putting it down. It's a very engaging and relatable story.
Is that so? Well, next I'm going to ask her about the book, even though I already know what it's about. What's the story about, anyway?
Well, basically it's about this brother scam that was turned into a human experiment prison.
Yep, and the main character.
And the people trapped here have the trait that turns them into a killing machine that lasts for blood.
Yeah, wait.
But the facility gets even worse, and they start to select the breeding people by cutting off their limbs and affixing them to... Uh-oh, that might be a little bit of a spoiler. But anyway, I'm really into it. The book, I mean. And not the thing about the limbs.
What? That's the story, yes. But something's wrong. She mentioned details in the book that are already spoilers. She didn't mention the synopsis where the main character has to find friends that she can trust.
Are you not a fan of that sort of thing, Ellie?
No, it's not that. I mean, I can definitely enjoy these kinds of stories, so don't worry.
I hope so.
Sorry, Yuri, that was a lie. Once I got to the limb cutting, it reminded me of something unpleasant. I'm trying my best not to become sick here. No, bad memory. Erase. Repress. Can't picture her like that just yet.
It's just that this kind of story, it's kind of thing that the kind that challenges you look at life from a strange new perspective. What all brings up, and not just because someone wants to be evil, but because the world is full of horrible people, and we're all worthless anyway. Then suddenly...
Well, what the hell was that? Player, can you check the dialogue history, please? Sure! Lots of whys. It's actually all still there. Oh, jeez.
I'm rambling, aren't I? Not again. I'm sorry.
Girl, you didn't just ramble. I'm pretty sure that just now you almost had an existential crisis and a stroke. Ah, I can't blame you. Hey, don't apologize. I haven't lost interest or anything.
Well, I guess it's all right then. But I feel like I should let you know that I have this problem. When I let things like books and writing fill my thoughts, my whole...
Does that one disappear? I think that one does. Yeah. I'm sorry, your whole body gets what now?
I kind of forget to pay attention to other people, so I'm sorry if I end up saying something strange.
You already did, almost.
And please stop me if I start talking too much.
I really don't think you need to worry. That just means you're passionate about reading. The least I can do is listen. It's a literature club, after all.
Well, that's true.
In fact, I might as well get started reading it, right?
Yes.
Whoa, what the hell was that?
I mean, you don't have to do it, but...
what are you saying? Let me just get the book. I quickly retrieve the book that I had put into my bag. All right, it's fine if I sit here, right? I slip into the seat next to yours.
Yeah.
Are you sure? You seem a little apprehensive.
I'm sorry. It's not that I don't want you to. It's just something I've done for you to. That is, reading in company with someone.
I see. Well, just tell me if I end up distracting you or anything. Gotta keep a close watch, even if it's scary. Who knows when she'll start glitching again.
Oh, all right.
I open the book and start the prologue. Yep, read this before. The plot didn't change, so why did she not mention the true synopsis? Yuri is in the corner of my eye. I realize that she's not actually looking at her own book. I glance over. Looks like she's reading from my book instead.
Sorry. I was just so bathing in your body, can I think of something?
Well, player, let's pretend we didn't see you hear that, deal? It went by too fast. Yuri, you really apologize a lot, don't you?
I do. I don't really mean to. Sorry. I mean...
Sigh. I smile, or at least attempt to give her a knowing smile. Always two words. Here, this should work, right? I slide my desk until it's up against Yuri's, then hold my book more between the two of them.
I suppose so.
Yuri timidly closes her own copy. Once we each lean in a little bit, our shoulders are almost touching. It feels like my left arm is in the way, so instead I use my right hand to hold the book. I guess that makes it kind of difficult to turn the page.
Yuri
takes her left arm and holds the left side of the book between her thumb and forehand. I do the same with my right arm and on the right side of the book. We're in the same position as the previous playthrough. And now it's actually kind of scaring me. I can feel the warmth from Yuri's face, and she's in the corner of my vision. If she goes crazy, the next second I won't be able to run.
Are you ready?
Eh?
To turn the page?
Sorry. I think I got a bit distracted for a second. I glance over at Yuri's face again, and our eyes meet. I don't know how I'll be able to keep up with her.
That's okay. You're not as used to reading, right? I don't mind being patient if it takes you a bit longer. It's probably the least I can do, since you've been so patient with me.
Yeah, thanks. We continue the first chapter in silence. Good thing she didn't notice me turning the pages faster than the last playthrough. God, this is getting awkward. I gotta make this conversation. Hey, Yuri. This might be a little silly thought, but the main character kind of reminds me of you a little bit.
No, I don't really like this character at all. Definitely not.
Really? What's with the defensive denial? I was just thinking the way she second-guesses things she says and that, all that.
That's what you were talking about. Sorry. I thought you meant something else about her.
Something else? Wait, no. The main character. Also, when she's being hurt. When she's in a fight, she smiles all the time, especially when she's bleeding. God damn it.
Never mind. We didn't even get that far yet, so I don't know why that came into my head.
Well, then why would he mention stuff? Whatever. Whoa, her laughter's shrill. Are you feeling all right?
You can rest if...
You're feeling sick or something. Your breathing is a little...
My breathing?
Shafira puts her hands on her chest, as if to feel her heartbeat. She's almost hyperventilating. Her breathing is light, short, and rapid.
I didn't even notice. Anyway, I'm fine. I just need some water.
All right, don't push yourself. Yuri stands up and practically rushes out of the classroom. She's getting excited. Maybe too excited to be reading with me. Yandere levels are growing. This ain't good.
Allie, did something happen just now?
You have the audacity to ask me that? Oh? I have no idea. Yuri was acting strange just now. Did someone mess with her head again? I wonder... Wait, was that a question mark period? Did I just say... Oh, I totally did. Question mark period.
I only did what I had to do. She always had these disturbing qualities. All I did was showing you who she really is under that mask. Don't need this ING. By intensifying those ugly qualities and lowering her mental inhibitors. Lowering her sense of shame and fear, destroying her mask. You will get to hear her in her most voice and see her true self. A shameless, perverted, self-harming masochist. Complete with a sexual habit of cutting herself with a pocket knife she brings to school whenever she feels super excited.
You. Have you no shame toying with people's minds like this? That's not even her true self. You're just showing us her dark side. Sure, she loves knives, but she never wanted to harm herself. That's not true.
The fact that she is capable of developing such a fetish should be enough reason for you to hate her. She's an insane woman who cuts herself for sexual thrillment. Doesn't that disgust you?
Well, actually, this is open to interpretation. You're the one that caused her to have that harmful kink in the first place! You think players gonna love you for corrupting someone like this? Are you that stupid? Well?
Oh, sorry. To answer your question, I honestly don't care at this point. I'm just making sure that I get what I deserve. The player realizes that there's no real or other choice, and the only way to save this world, to save my reality, is to save me. And to love me, and me alone. That's when I can finally stop.
You? How can she say that with such a serene smile? She's crazier than Yuri.
Don't worry about me, you silly main character. You should worry about yourself more, you know. And player, please just consider me as your perfect companion, okay? I'm not a closet knife fetishist yandere like Yuri. I am not a childish tsundere like Yuri, or Natsuki. And I don't have crippling depression like Sayori. It doesn't even exist anymore. I'm just your normal, friendly, and determined literature club president. Desperate for your affection in this pointless world made out of zeros and ones. As you can see, I am perfect.
Disgusting. She's pretty much being a yandere at this point. Why bother hiding it? She is actually insane.
Anyways, there's still a time before we share our bones together. Why don't we stop this chit-chat and chill out for a little while? Wow, that's a scary lair. I would say don't get in my way, but I guess the more appropriate dialogue here is... Just try to get in my way. It will make a difference. Well, have fun.
Monica left with a smug smile on her face. I stand up. This bitch, it's as if she's asking to be stabbed a second time. You want it? I'll fucking do it again, you motherfucker. Gah! No, calm down. Hold together. I can't go crazy. Not now. I take a few deep breaths. Okay, I regain my calm. I then slip the book back into my bag. Okay, now. Natsuki's rummaging around the closet. Alright, we'll pick up with that second exclusive next time because, well, actually, I need to stop because, like I mentioned earlier, I need to get to bed because I'm recording very late and I need to record the rest of the morning because I'm bad at life sometimes. But I'm not going to do the outro because it's not the on session. Bye!